In scoliosis, the deformity in adolescence, we kind of have three general categories of treatment options. We can do observation, the middle category is bracing, and the last resort category is surgery, which all of our goals are try to get it from getting to the surgery category. So the brace category is our intermediary group, curves typically there between 25 and 35 or 40 degrees, that we now have very good evidence, scientific evidence, that bracing can diminish the rate of progression and or the incidence of progression and diminish the amount of surgery needs to be done. The two biggest variables for curve progression are the size of the curve and the amount of growth remaining. If you're done growing and your curve's less than 35 or 40 degrees, you're going to be fine and you don't need surgery. We have some natural history studies that show us that curves, once they get over 50 degrees, will continue to progress into adult years. And so that's where it becomes a discussion. Not all of those need surgery. So commonly there'll be discussions about, can we wait and watch? And yes is usually the answer at that point. The patients that we're doing this surgery on, their risk is that if we don't do the surgery, the curve will likely continue to progress into their adult years. When we do surgery, the after effects of surgery, there's pluses and minuses always. The plus side is that we're going to hopefully improve the alignment, that's the goal, safely, and get it to stay in that newly improved alignment so that it doesn't continue to progress. The downsides on the surgery are putting rods and screws in your back certainly doesn't make you more flexible. To minimize that impact, we try to fuse as few levels as possible so that we can minimize the impact on loss of mobility.